Hi, this is Dreama, and today we are doing a client reading. And as always, I know the name of the client, and they know their name, but I won't be saying it in this video. Now, today's reading is a how does he or she feel love reading. And we're going to be using the Legacy of the Divine Tarot. It's one of my very favorite decks, one that I am quite connected to. And today we're going to be using a 3-card spread. And I'll explain it once I get it laid out. Okay, now how this is going to work is I know the name of the client and they know their name, but I won't be saying it in this video. Now, like I said, this is a how does he or she feel reading, which means it's in the moment. It's how does this other person feel about the client right now, okay? And how this is going to work is this card here will represent what I call the sex card. And it'll tell us if there is any kind of sexual attraction between this person and the client, and, you know, possibly how strong, things like that. Next is what I call the connection card. Now, this card will tell us if they have a spiritual or emotional connection to the client in any way, okay? And last, we have the love card. Now, this card will help us understand if there is any love between this person and the client, and what kind of love does that person feel right now, okay? We're going to start with the sex card. Okay, and we have the 3 of Coins. Now, that is an interesting card as it pertains to the sex card. What I'm getting from this card is that there is a strong sexual attraction that this person feels for the client. And as you can see from the card, this person is working very hard on this one coin, and there are other coins above. So what that tells me is that although there are other things going on in this person's life, possibly even some other people that may be around them, the clients, this person is really concentrating on the client. That seems to be where all their sexual energy is going at the moment. Now, that doesn't mean that they're actually telling the client that. This is something they could be keeping to themselves. However, it is very concentrated at this time, okay? Next is our connection card. And we have the 9 of Wands. Now, this is interesting. If you see, the man is kind of bent over, he's holding one wand, there are these other wands behind him. Now, what I'm getting from this is that there is a very strong spiritual connection between this other person and the client. However, right now, it looks as though what this person is trying to do is pause it. They're trying to stop and pause this and push down this connection. It's something that they are wanting to pretty much keep well within themselves. This is not something that they are going to be sharing with people right now, okay? Last is our love card, and we have the Knight of Cups. Now, this is an interesting card because I'm not sure if you can see it, but there's a knight and there's actually some water down here and things like that. This is a very strong card. And so what this tells me is that yes, there is a very strong love connection that this person has for the client. However, for some reason, they want to put on a strong front and not let anyone see what they're really feeling, okay? All right, that does conclude my reading for today. And I would like to thank everyone for joining me, and I do hope to see you all again.